Hello, Trendy Day reporting in.
Hey, Trendies, what's up? Uploaded 3 videos today. One of them was the cannabis strain update, which has almost 1,000 hits. So I want to thank you guys for your interest in the strains I'm growing. Got a few nasty little fucktards on that video, leaving nasty messages. Let's go through a couple of them. This one guy says, yellow leaves, scrawny plants, what the fuck is everyone watching the same video? Okay, I'm watching my video right now. There aren't any yellow leaves, really. I mean, there might be one or two for nitrogen deficiencies here and there, but when you're dealing with, 10 different strains, getting the nutrients right for every single one of them is a pain in the ass, so I just do a blanket nutrient on everything. And, some of them do really good, some of them not as good, some of them do average. So I think I've got it pretty good. I'm really happy with actually the health of my plants. I'm not concerned about any of them dying or anything like that. But this guy, let's see, Mr. Keg, 1, 2, 3, 4. Dude, you don't have to watch my videos anymore, dude. Nobody fucking asked you to fucking come over here and look at my shit. So if you're not trendy and if you don't appreciate the shit I put out there, you can go fuck off. So when I get someone like that, I just go right here, and the first thing I do is I hit block user, because he can go fuck himself. And then the second thing I do is I remove their stupid fucking comment. Forever. Never to hear from that asshole again. It's easy, it's quick, it's painless for me, and it's wonderful. And it's amazing at how fast I do that and get rid of somebody's negative comment. How quickly I forget all about that person completely. So let's move on, because there were a couple of negative comments here. This guy, I'm so honored. This guy actually started his own account just to troll me. This account is called Nay Sucks. Instead of even wasting my time with the comment, I'm going to show you guys how to deal with shit like this. Click on the name. It's using my name without my permission. That's fine. And then go to, if you look, there's a couple of options right here. You've got a down arrow right here that you can click on that says block user or send message. Don't waste your time there. Instead, scroll all the way down here, and if you look down at the bottom right, you'll see a little flag button. It says report. Click the down arrow next to that and scroll down and check out your options there. And you've got three options. One says background image, one says report profile thumb, and one says report user. Okay, click on report user, and then it gives you what is the issue: harassment, cyberbullying, impersonation, violent threats, child endangerment, hate speech, none of these. Okay, harassment and cyberbullying, that's a good one, so click that. Then you get a notification that says, please remember, they want to know if it meets the threshold of harassment or not, whatever. Yeah, I hit confirm, and that says, harassment and cyberbullying, a user stolen my videos, a user is revealing my personal information, a user is harassing me on the site, a user is attacking or belittling someone else. Okay, I'll go to a user's harassing me on the site. And then it says enter the username or channel of the person you want to report. It comes up automatically because this is from their flag on their page. So it comes up with the name Nay Sucks. So you click, here, let me move out of the way just a little bit. So you click right here where it says continue. And now they want to know where the comment is that this person left that's harassing me. He's left several videos. He's left several comments on several of my videos, and they all come up on this page. It's really helpful. One of them came up yesterday, and two of them came up today. One of them says, your grows and your little water feature sucks balls. You need to watch some real growers and blah, 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 whatever. Okay, all you do is you select the messages that these guys leave. And then you scroll down. And now you can put an additional note, and I'll put an additional note. This user is using my name on his channel without my permission. Please remove this user's account. Thank you. And then hit the submit button. Now, what's beautiful? Go back to your page. We'll go back to my page right here.
Hey, Trendy, is Trendy reporting in from the group?
And now go back to where his post was and go click on it, click block user, just like the other one, and then click OK, and then click remove. And now he's gone forever, too, and he's blocked. Not only that, but now YouTube's going to spend a little time researching, and if they don't like what they see, they will remove that account completely from YouTube. So that's how I deal with a troll, if somebody comes in and they're making stupid fucking comments. Now here's another one right here. This guy called me a fucking kike. Tisk tisk. Now that's racial. So that's even worse than just a regular troll. This is a guy who's really going to get in trouble. So let's deal with him. I'll show you how we deal with him. I go to his page, and he's got Adolf Hitler as his profile picture, and he's got Nazi theme song and a couple of German things, and then cannabis strain update. Okay, whatever. I guess I'm supposed to be impressed or scared or whatever. But this is how we deal with these people. Go to the page, click report, and this time when you report the user, go to hate speech against a protected group. Boom. All right. Hate speech. We encourage free speech and defend everyone's rights to speak whatever on unpopular points of view. Please select the protected group. Race or ethnic, nationality, religious. We can go with any of these. This says Muslims, Christians, so that's us. We're going to click religious. Then we're going to enter username or channel. It already comes up. And then we click continue. And then we scroll down, and we can find some of this guy's hate speech right here where he says fucking kike, okay? So we just check that little box and type a nice little note for YouTube. Please remove this user's account for religious... what do they call it? Oh, hate speech. For hate speech. That's great. For hate speech. Spell speech right. Oops. Thank you. Submit. Easy, right? Let's go back a couple. We're just going to go back to my page and do the same thing. We go here, pause my video, go here, and go to block first, block the user first, and then remove. And now that person's gone out of my life forever. It's that simple. So I'm doing this nice and slow so you guys can see what I'm doing, but I want you to realize that it's really easy, it's really fast. And it will take you all, once you do it, it'll take you all of about 10 seconds to fill out one of these forms. So these people are usually, they're worth about 10 seconds of my fucking time. And that's all. So, you know, if I can do it quickly and get them and get it dealt with and move on with my life, that's exactly what I'm here for. That's exactly what I want to do. So let me just go on and see if there's anything else. People asking a lot of questions on this thread. Really good posts, really good messages from all of you guys. I really appreciate that. I'm so fucking jealous of you, Trendy. Thank you, Ample Confusion. That's funny. And that's it. That's it. A lot of other. It's a lot of love I get. That's a lot of love when I look at the posts I get from people. It's like I get one or two troll comments, and then the rest is all just wonderful, trendy love. So I keep doing what I'm doing, and I want you all to know that these little fucktards aren't going to stop me doing what I'm doing. It's usually the people who do this are the people who got blocked the day before, and then they move on real quickly. So, it's best just to deal with it, and the whole reason I wanted to make this video was to show you how to deal with it, and to show you that it's no big deal. And, also to show you that, that it's a great time right now to get high. That's what I feel like doing. So let's do it.
Oh.
Oh. Let's see here. Take some of these leaves off. Break the bud apart. I'll answer some of these questions while we're getting high. How about that? It's Dolch. Dolch left me a message, and somebody else said, I would really love to try out one of your buds. You should spread your buds over the Cali area. Ha ha ha. I will eventually. That's the whole point of this, you know, is to get people to experience some of these great medical strains, man, you know. So we'll talk about that. Man, that banana kush, I need that in my life. Where can I get some beans of that stain? Jimmy Grow wants to know. I'm sure you could find it online, man. Just search Attitude Seeds, probably has it, or there's a lot of seed banks out there. Just Google the strain, and the seed bank will probably come right up. You guys grow so much. Is it all for personal use? Yes, it is all for personal use, just not my personal use. It's for a lot of other people's personal use as well. When I finish my crop, it goes to the dispensary where it's sold legally to a bunch of California state residents with medical marijuana cards, and that's where it goes. Kush Smoker, in reply to a troll, you're a motherfucking troll, idiot. Shut the fuck up. You don't know shit. So fuck off this channel, you sad fuck. I want to say to Kush Smoker, thank you. I really love when you guys address the trolls on my channel. I love it. Please. Please have at them. It's just that much less work that I have to do. And then this guy says either too much watering or not enough to Dora, who said, my top leaves are drooping, not curling. Can anyone help? Either too much watering or not enough. Now, if your top leaves are drooping, that's going to be too much light or heat. So, too much light or heat. Did you transplant recently? And it's that could be oxygen deprivation, too. Like you said, too much water. It could be too much water. And it could be not enough water too, if the plant is, that's the whole plant droops when it needs water. So I don't think if it's just the top leaves, okay? Top leaves sounds like oxygen depth, sounds like it could be flooded. Could be flooded. Is it too wet? Maybe stop watering. All right, maybe that'll help them, hopefully. We'll see. That was Tadora. Hey, can anyone tell me which soil is the best to grow in and where can I get it? The best soil to grow in, I don't know the best soil, but I can recommend some soil that I use. I use Happy Frog from Fox Farms, and I mix that with a third compost and a third of perlite. That is a great mix right there. And then throw newts in if we're doing outdoor. Talk about water, nay. Tap and row, rock on, Maine. Talk about water. I don't understand that. Let's keep moving on through these. somebody wants to know, Sticky Green Bud, are all of those plants females? Yes, of course. All of my plants are female. How do you grow bud? How do you grow great bud without deficiencies? Well, you supply everything the plant wants. So this is how you do it. You look at the plant, you see what it needs. If the leaves start turning yellow, you know to give it a little more nitrogen. And you make sure that you check your pH. You make sure you check your PPMs so you don't lock out the nutrients to the roots. Hopefully some of that information will help. Okay, hey Nay, I was just curious how the smell is inside the grow room. From your experience with the sweet Mary Jane, do you think the smell would be noticeable from outside a room if you grew Northern Lights? Man, I've never grown a big room of Northern Lights, but all marijuana smells somewhat. So all you got to do is get a carbon filter and put it in the room. They're not very expensive. Just a carbon filter with a small fan sitting right on top of it. Get a 4-inch fan and a 4-inch carbon filter output. Boom. That'll take care of you. Are you using light deprivation techniques for the greenhouse from baby bud raws, blood raws, baba blood, whatever your name is? Are you using light deprivation? No, of course not. We're outdoor. This time of year, plants flower naturally. So no, I'm not using light dep. I'm just going natural. Don't you just hate when phones do that? Oh, yeah, that's right. Love your plants. What's your secret for nice, healthy, and bushy plants? Nay, shit is strong. I want to grow some king crowns. Cheers. I'm running GH Florinova full newt line, but I want to try the three-part. Okay. I don't recommend General Hydro unless I'm running hydroponics. I've used it. It's okay, but it's not spectacular. Maybe if I was using General Hydroponics with additives, I would have been happier. But back then, I wasn't using additives. Not a lot of them, so. My secret for nice, healthy, and bushy plants is get a nice, healthy, bushy strain. That's one thing. If you get a sativa, you're not going to get a healthy, bushy plant. You're going to get a healthy, huge, sprawling, vine-like plant. So strain is very important. Like these Afghan Kushes I have, they're so bushy and awesome. Nay's Ultra Jack is another one. Strain is important. Second, you can trim the plants around if you're making a mother plant. You could trim them and turn them into a bonsai. Shape them however you want. When you're cutting clones, or just trim them off, you know, whatever. They'll grow more. And for healthiness, InVeg Super Thrive. I really, really, really recommend that product, Super Thrive. It's got just about a little bit of everything that your plants need. So get Super Thrive. CalMag is a great one. Protect is a great one. And Liquid Karma is a great additive. So look at those four additives: Super Thrive, ProMag, CalMag, and Protect. Okay? There you go. That's my secret. Let's see. Hella cool, man. Okay, I think that's the end of it. Yeah. Yeah, all right. So that was fun reading through all of those. I thank you so much for sending in your questions, and I do not mind answering them as long as they're not stupid fucking questions. For instance, I already blocked someone off this thread today, and I took their question off, and I blocked them because I do not want to hear from people like this who are requesting that I put some sort of video showing the BHO process. Don't ask me. I will block you, and I will remove you from my channel, okay? So don't ask me to do that shit. I've said it before in older videos. Do not request that I show the process of creating BHO. I'm not going to do that, okay? So don't ask. You want to know why? You can fucking figure it out. Figure it out on your own. That's what's up, okay? So, like I said, I do not appreciate stupid fucking questions. So your best bet is to educate yourself a little bit before you send me a stupid fucking question. Like I said, I don't mind you sending me questions as long as they're not stupid fucking questions. All right, asking me to put something on there that I obviously would have done a long time ago if there wasn't an issue around it is pointless, and it's a waste of my time, it's a waste of your time, and it's going to get your question removed and your account blocked from my account. So fucking don't ask me to fucking show the making of BHO, okay? All right, I'm glad I've got that out there. Hopefully, you know, some of you will fucking listen. The thing is, I don't particularly mind when people ask me questions that they don't know the answer to, even if they're new and they're like, oh, I'm new, I don't know, but blah 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 blah, and then they ask me a question and I just think it's a very stupid question. I don't mind as long as it's not asking me to do something illegal or asking me to do something stupid or, you know, trying to put me in some kind of a fucked up light or something. So, hey, Keepstone, what's up, buddy? I'm making a video right now, just so y'all know. Hey, Oscar, thank you for making me feel special. Love you too, bro. You're awesome. All right. So I guess Satellite Man dropped his bong. What'd you do, Satellite Man? What'd you do to your bong? He's talking. He dropped it in slow motion. Okay. As long as he didn't break it. So, anyway, yeah, let's get back to stupid questions. So, like I was saying before, I don't mind stupid questions from new people as long as they're not intentionally based to you know, create some sort of sideways bullshit, which is when someone asks me, "Hey, Nay, yeah, why don't you fucking put a video of you up making a fucking BHO?" You know, when you say shit like that without realizing why I don't do it, it makes you look pretty fucking stupid. Let's talk about it. State of California still has a law on the books that says concentrates are illegal. You're not allowed to make them. You're not allowed to possess them. I've had lots of friends got pulled over with oil and BHO and things like that, and they end up usually... They usually get off, but they get caught and they do get their shit taken away from them and they get charged. So until that changes, I would absolutely not put any sort of illegal activity on Trendy Ass Dabber's channel. It's just not smart. It's not a smart thing to do. Anything that I can go run up to the dispensary and go buy, like if I can go buy BHO, which I can, I don't mind smoking it on a video, because I don't feel like I'm really breaking the law. But I'm not going to sit here and manufacture it for any fucking person out there who doesn't like me to grab a hold of that video and send it in and say, look what this guy's doing on the internet. No. Can't do that. So, if you're going to ask me to do it, I'm going to block you, because I don't like people asking me to break the law. So I'm not asking you to break the law. Please don't ask me to do it. I don't. If you're fucking that stupid after I put something like this out, I've said it so many times, but after I say this repeatedly, and you're going to keep asking me, I'll just do away with you. Be gone with you. Just like that. I mean, if you really want to know how to make fucking VHO, you might as well just fucking come into fucking Stickcam. You know, and ask questions. That's where they're live people all the time that know all about that shit. That's why the chat is up, okay? I can't put everything on the fucking video. But I don't mind talking. But the link is on every video just about that I put up there, so if you ever need to talk or you ever have a question, it's not hard to hit us up. This is going to be good, sitting here staring it down before I smoke it. Alright. Cheers. Wow, 100 degrees outside. Let's see how my outdoors are looking. Make sure they're not sad in the heat. They look alright. I'm in Northern California, Ty. Way up north. All right. So, man, I am sweating profusely. Holy shit. I put a little oil on that. Doesn't take much. Especially when it's close. Ty, what the fuck? Come over. Let's do some dabs, bro. Ty, you're less than an hour from my house. You gotta come over and do some dabs with me. Come on up. Found out Ty Stick lives nearby. That's pretty fucking cool. You only live 14 hours from me? That's funny. I saw live turkeys. Ty, you need to come up here, bro. Come on, do some dabs with me. Yeah, come on out. Come do some dabs with Trendini. He's less than an hour from my house. Christiania in Denmark. I've been there. Got a big old bass, this roar. It's funny. Yeah, Cyber took me there. Cyber took me to Christiania. Let me tell you about Christiania, dude. It's a nice place to visit. I wouldn't want to spend too much time there. End up getting your shit fucking robbed. There are some shady characters out there. And some really tight spots, too. And you're walking around those buildings and shit. It's like, man, they got that shit marked. If you see on the buildings, they've got red spray paint marked with a fucking symbol. If you see that symbol, You can't have your camera out, and if you do, they get fucking pissed. They'll fucking grab your camera and take the fucking, they'll delete all your shit. They're real fucking strict over there. It's like this massive, massive group paranoia inside that place. You can ask Cyber, he'll explain it to you. Everyone there is super paranoid, and they're real crazy. Yeah, dude. We wanted to eat while we were there. I was really hungry while we were at Christiania. I was like, let's see if they got a restaurant. Dude, we walked into this restaurant, and it was like a pool hall. It was kind of set up like a bar. You walk in, and there was a cigarette. There was an ashtray at every table, and when you open the door, cigarette smoke comes pouring out of the fucking building in your face. So we walked in, looked around, like, okay, that's interesting, turned around, walked out. Couldn't imagine eating in there. Oh. Yeah, I guess he got some really good hash there from time to time. It just depended on who the vendor was. If his guy was there when he would go, you know, the same guy was there, would have really good shit. Sometimes his guy wouldn't be there, and he'd have to buy from other unscrupulous sources, and sometimes he would get ripped off and shit. He'd come back with stories. Over the years, yeah, because that was where he used to get it. Over the years, when him and I were smoking, I'd hear Christiania stories. He's like, oh, I got back from Christiania, man, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, Cyber's got some great fucking stories about that shit. He could tell you. Christiania? I think it's Christiania. Like Christian Ea. I think. Yeah, I'm ready. Cheers. God, the Afghan Kush is kick ass. Holy fuck. Kefir, you're stupid. Stupid! You're gonna smoke tobacco, dude? Sit there and say you like... I like it. I like it. I think I'll keep smoking the fucking cancer. That's real smart. Fuck that shit. Dude, they spray that shit with poison. You know they do, Kefir. It's like, he knows what they fucking spray that shit with. He could probably tell you the fucking chemicals they spray on it. What do they spray on tobacco, Kefir? What do they fly over and spray on tobacco, Kefir? Tell us. Tell us. I want to know. Shit called, like, DDT. Stuff that's not good for us. The wrap that's made out of tobacco? Is that what you mean, Chronic? The wrap that's made out of tobacco? You mean the tobacco leaf that you're going to smoke? Is that what you mean? Is that what you're talking about? Because if you are, then you're not throwing it away. You're smoking it. I know there's a lot of blunt smokers out there, but I wish y'all would fucking reconsider it, because when y'all get lung cancer, it's going to make us look bad. You know, people are going to be like, oh, he smoked weed all the time, that's why he got lung cancer. Well, don't forget, he was smoking tobacco, too. You know? That's why I used to say to Cyber, that's how I got Cyber to stop that shit, finally. Mixing. I think Hash Bean still does it, though. Still takes tobacco, mixes it, he fucking dries it in tin foil for like a half hour, he holds it over a candle. Like a crackhead. Then he takes that tobacco and he mixes it with his weed. Oh, does that reek, too. God, when we were in Amsterdam together, Hashbean was fucking smoking that shit. Him and Batty and the dude that was the administrator for the site, Cannabis Chat, the three of them were downstairs. They had a separate apartment, a whole floor away from where all the Cannabis Chatters were, just for tobacco mixing smoke. They had bongs set up down there, tobacco. They'd sit down there and fucking mix their tobacco and shit. Yeah, it reeked. It reeked. You'd walk by the door and you could just smell it. Ugh. Ugh, it was disgusting. And they kept asking around, oh, you should come down and try. You should come down and try a mix hit, man. I'd be like, fuck you. And then they'd be like, hey, because they know I'd throw up. That shit will make me fucking throw up instantly. I'd fucking get dizzy and bleh. I couldn't imagine. Not for me. Not for me. So I used to, but I fucking learned. I used to smoke cigarettes. Oh, God, I'm so glad I quit that shit. The easiest way to quit smoking cigarettes, every time you get the urge, just smoke a bowl. You'll be fine. You might go through a little bit more weed, but you'll be fine. You're lucky. Don't ever start. It's hard to quit. Just ask fucking Dino. He walks around with two fucking nicotine patches on his shoulders and still smokes a cigarette. He's got an e-cigarette, which is great. He's got the fucking e-cigarette. I took a drag off of that, and I was like, wow, I was impressed. I was like, damn, that is kind of good. You know, it tasted like vanilla, kind of. And he says you can smoke them on a fucking airplane. Smoke them in restaurants in California. And if you're sitting right next to him, you can't even smell it. You can't even fucking smell it. It dissolves into the air. It is crazy. I just grabbed me some Nays Ultra Dad. Dude, I made a video the other day. And I'm sure it's posted by now. I hope I posted it. It's the one where the fucking bottle popped and scared me. Do you guys see that shit? This right here. You hear that? Yeah, like right now. Now it's set in. And I'll set it down. And you know what? When I'm least expecting it, ping! It scared the shit out of me. It's kind of fun. It's kind of spooky. Kind of like going into a haunted house. Without being prepared for it. Without knowing you're going into a haunted house. Which, basically, that's my MO, so. Yay, Halloween's right around the corner, man. I'm going to get all my robotic spooky shit out. Get it all trying to work and shit. Start plugging in my weird shit. This is some Nays Ultra Jack. Let's see. It's a little leafy because I didn't trim it good. Let me grab something without so much leaf on it. There we go. There we go. Oh God, I went out in the grow today. I went down to the big grow, me and Dino's grow. And it's finally gotten to the point where I can smell all of the strains just about. A lot of the strains. There's a few of the strains down there are, they're still not developed yet. They're still they've developed their bud sites, but the buds haven't come in. So I walk down there, and what I like to do is like say this is a bud. You know, in the middle of my hand is a bud, and these are all the leaves coming up. I'll take my fingers and I'll go underneath from the stalk, and I'll rub my finger underneath the leaf a little bit, and then I'll smell my fingers, and I can basically get a really good sense of what the buds are going to smell like. And I went around it to a lot of them. I smelled the Purple Wreck, Sour D, the Banana Kush. But I got to tell you, I smelled this one strain that Dino brought. It's called Dawn, D-O-N, like the Dawn. You guys ever heard of that strain? Talk about a fucking over-the-top candy smell. So sweet and so just, oh my God. And it's not like... like not enjoyable candy, like not like UK cheese, like fucking candy. Oh my God. Oh, Don chocolate chunk. Let me see. Yeah, I'm still waiting for a couple. I'm still waiting for the fucking incredible to get a little bigger. I'm waiting for the cherry pie. There's two cherry pies, one at each end. I'm waiting for the Blue Sky cotton candies. There's one at each end. God, that's funny, man. There's one at the front and one at the back. I'm waiting for the sour kush and the black and sour. The black and sour I smelled. It smells good. Oh my God. All right, man. Offscript's always pushing me, man. He's like, man, he's like a goddamn bong hit coach. He's like, come on, Nate, let's hit it. Let's keep up the pace. You're a bum. You're a bum. Catch that chicken. All right. I said I'll catch the goddamn chicken, man. Holy shit. Top of the hour. That's what we'll call this. Top of the hour. You ready? 30 seconds, you said? Kepper's going to smoke a bong hit every 5 minutes. Kepper, but the bong hits have to be long bong hits. They can't be little tiny rips. They got to be big man hits. Oh, those little ants. They're on my fucking bird feeder again. I'm going to have to go out there and do some killing. I'll kill me a fucking sugar ant. Cheers. Thank you, sir. In the middle of making a video right now. So, yeah. I got ants to kill. All I have to do is take my bug spray out there and spray right at the fucking on the baseboard, on the eave board. Just spray right where the ants walk. towards the thing, and they go right to it, and they fucking walk right into it. Psh, dead. They just freeze. I hate them. I hate those little fucking ants so much. Because it's like, I hang these hummingbird feeders up. Hey, Roscoe, what's up, buddy? Come here. Come here.
Let's say hey to Roscoe.
Come here, Roscoe. Come here. Come here, buddy. What's up? Come here. Hey. He just woke up. What's up, buddy? Who is that on TV? Is that the trendy-ass dabbers? Is that all the trendy-ass dabbers up there? Who is that? Are you looking to see who you see? Who do you see? He's like, I see a bunch of trendies. I see some trendies.
Good boy.
Oh! Yeah, there is a downside to rehydrating your bud with lettuce. I'm glad you asked. Instead, get yourself some bottled water and get some Q-tips or a cotton ball. Take the Q-tips and dip it in the water and throw the buds in a jar, a sealed jar, Tupperware container with a wet Q-tip. The buds will absorb that water, whereas if you put lettuce in there, it'll absorb that lettuce smell, and the buds will taste and smell like lettuce. You're better off with just pure water. You'll make your buds smell and taste like lettuce. You don't want that. Hay usually is bud that hasn't been cured properly. It smells like hay. It's that wet smell that needs to go away before you can actually smell the bud. Yeah. It may have been pulled early too. What's up, little dog? What's up, little dog? You're a baby boy, you are. Yes, you are. Look at you. Oh, man. I got to get the bug spray, man. I got to get the bug spray, man. I want to do it right now. Because I know it'll just take a second. I'll run a loop real quick. I'm going to run a loop.
bastards.
I took care of them. I took care of business.
Hey man, did you guys see that tribute video? That fuck you tribute video? Did you guys see that shit?
Oh, I'm so glad you didn't see it. I'm so happy right now that I'm showing somebody something that they have not seen yet. I'm gonna show a specimen as a hand. You have not seen it? I'm so excited. I'm so excited. Okay, I want all of you to watch this video and turn up your volumes so we can all hear it reverberating. Everywhere. It's phenomenal. I didn't put it up. I don't know who did it. I don't know that person. Oh yeah. That's what I told him. It starts with an F. That is phenomenal. That's the kind of shit I like. Oh, nice. Nice. How many views does it have now? Let's see. Oh, under 100. Under 100. Oh. It's got... 81. I kind of want to watch it now. It's funny. I guess I'll watch it. Priceless. The trendy tribute video. The trendy tribute, the parts one and two, those two videos. All right, so now. So it's like 4:20, man. It's like 4:20, man. There, it's 4:20. It's 4:20. It's 4:20, man. Am I right or am I right? No? Man, I'm sure it's 4:20 somewhere, for God's sakes. Let me see here. Where's the 4:20 at? Where's my time at? Oh. There we go, World Talk. No, I guess it's not 4:20 anywhere. That's weird. I guess it's not 4:20 anywhere, man. In Texas, man. It's 4:20 in Texas, man. It's 4 is fucking Dole Chat. It's 4:20 in Texas. Cheers. Hit subscribe. Thanks for watching my videos. Happy 420. Legalize everywhere. Peace. Come out to Stick Cam. Chill. Click the link below.